Beautiful people, it is Ivy here today, and today I have a brand new video for you all. As you can see by the title of the video, I'm going to be doing formal prom dresses for small boob girls and even just ones in general. They're really super affordable and I guess a more cheaper option for those on a budget for their formal or prom, and we're just gonna get into the video. So I clearly don't dress like this all the time, but I thought I would wear this. I just finished filming the try-on portion of it all, and you know, I'm really feeling this look, so we're gonna stay like this. The first dress that I wanna show you guys is this dress. I have this dress, I actually thrifted it, I only bought it for $2. It's from the brand called Kukai. If you have heard of that, it's an Australian brand. It's kind of more of like a higher upper end brand, and it's a little bit expensive. So when I saw this at the thrift store, I was like, excuse me? It's just this like nice long black sleek dress. It like really plunges down a little bit, but I put a little safety pin on the side because I didn't want it to plunge down too much. And with the straps, I thought the straps were gonna be way too big, and I thought it was gonna plunge down really, really deep. But to make it a little bit more tighter, I just twisted the tops at the side. This dress is perfect for small boob girls like myself, because if you look at it, it doesn't really need a lot of support. You could definitely wear it like this and just rock the flat chest without using any sticky cups, but you can use these if you really, really want to. I would still probably recommend wearing like nipple covers or something, because you could have a little wardrobe malfunction in this at some point in the night. You're gonna be dancing all night. You really, really don't want your nipples showing in any photos or whilst on the dance floor or anything like that. I think this dress is perfect for formal and prom because it's that really nice mix of elegant and sexy, and also at the same time, you are super, super comfortable in it. You can eat a lot throughout formal, and because it's not very skin tight, you can have a food baby and it's going to be fine. When choosing formal or prom dresses in general, you probably want to find dresses that are going to be really comfortable for you to wear all night. Something that you are super comfortable in. You can wear a tight dress if you want to, if you're comfortable in that, or you could just wear a more flowy dress, whatever you're more comfortable with, just because you're actually going to be wearing it all night. I remember back in like when I went to high school, people used to say like, don't wear a black dress to formal, but I feel like times have changed. The next dress that I have to show you guys is this. So I actually got this on Wish. I did one of those like finding a wedding dress on Wish video like 2 years ago, and I bought these two dresses that I'm going to show you. I can't remember how much this was, but I believe it was something like around $25 to $30. The dress overall, the design and the style and the material is really, really nice. It's just, it is so thin. I was not wearing the appropriate underwear for this, which also is another prom tip. Wear the appropriate underwear. One that will A, you'll feel comfortable in for the whole night. Don't feel the need to wear like, I guess like a G-string or formal underwear throughout the whole night. It's gonna give you a wedgie all night because it's gonna be uncomfortable. And yeah, I have this. It is just like this kind of, I guess a little bit more higher neck, but not too high neck dress. This open back moment, and you can just like tie it up with a string and tie it up the back. And it's kind of got a little bit of a train. This does look a little bit like a wedding dress, but I guess the way you style it, you can make it look more formally with your accessories, such as your earrings, your necklace, and your bag, and the way that you do your hair. I did my hair in this sort of, I don't know how to describe it, just like half up, half down twist, and I didn't want to make it look super wedding-y. And I know a lot of people always say like, avoid wearing white on your formal, but honestly, I think it's fine if it flatters you and if it looks good and you really like the dress. I would say just go for it. We used to have all these silly rules for like formal and prom back when I was going to prom. I graduated in 2013, so I went to formal then. And everyone used to have these rules like, you can't wear black to formal, you can't wear white to formal, because you're either gonna look like you're gonna go to a funeral or a wedding. But honestly, if you find a dress that looks really, really good on you, just wear it. The next dress that I have to show you guys is another dress that I got from Wish. It is just a long gown. Again, it's got a train. It's got this floral lace detail, but it's got these like sleeves to go on the side to make it look like you have sleeves. It looks very ethereal, looks very nice, and it's got a really nice open back as well. I really, really love this dress, and I'm trying to figure out like an occasion to wear it, because honestly, I just feel like white long dresses all just look like wedding dresses in general. But yeah, I still think, again, with the right accessories, with the right hairstyling, you could definitely pull this off and make this not look like a wedding dress. It just really depends on, yeah, like again, how you style it and everything. And I think this is perfect for small boob girls because it's just quite kind of high neck. It doesn't droop down too low or anything like that, but it's got that beautiful open back, which I think will really accentuate your features. Open back things are very flattering to like small chested girls just because you actually are able to wear just like sticky cups or nipple covers, and you know, you don't need too much support in that area. And so having like high neckline with an open back, it's just really nice and really flattering. Whereas for someone with, I guess, bigger boobs, it would be a lot harder for them to wear like an open back kind of dress because of the fact that like they will have no support if they just don't wear a bra. And I know it'll be difficult for them in that sense. Another tip that I have for you guys for like formal and prom is it's probably best to tailor your dresses, especially if you are a short girl like me. It's really, really difficult when your dress is so long and you're tripping over it the whole night. So it's probably best to get your dress measured and tailored to your body. And as well as this dress is kind of loose in the shoulder areas, so if I wasn't like careful, it could just fall down throughout the night. You really don't want that, especially when you're dancing and you're like dancing around and having to like pull up the straps of your shoulders the whole night. It's just so uncomfortable. So again, just to make yourself the most comfortable that you can, get your dress tailored and try to get it tailored just once, like just very, very close to your actual formal slash prom day, like a month out. Just get it tailored because that's super key. I remember when I was in high school, there was this girl that literally got her dress tailored like 3 times throughout the year. I believe she's like going on a diet and trying to lose weight, but me and my friends were like, that is so excessive. Like, that is so much money that you're spending on tailoring each time. Why don't you just get like the final tailor at the end? And so, yeah, you don't have to spend that much money, but would still recommend. The next dress that I have to show you guys is this dress. So I got this dress at a thrift store. I actually bought this dress for $1, just $1. It is amazing. It's not like in tip-top condition, but you know, we can make it work. So this was originally from Misguided. It is this super high neck, and this is actually like high neck. It comes up to the top of your neck like this, and then crisscross in the back. Very, very nice open back. It's got like these really, really skinny spaghetti straps. What I mean by it's not in like tip-top condition is that like, if you look very closely at this, the straps are kind of broken at the front and kind of pulling apart, kind of ripping. And I feel like the best way that you could probably go about this if you want to repair dresses like this from the thrift store is to just cut it from the top and then sew it back in the parts that's not damaged or ripped or anything like that. This dress is amazing. Again, it's too long for me. I made the mistake of wearing this to a wedding all day. So it wasn't just like formal wear, it was like all afternoon picture taking and then all night. I actually wore this from like 10 a.m. in the morning till like 11 p.m. at night, and I was tripping over my dress the whole night. I had to keep holding it and it was just so uncomfortable. So like I said, get your things tailored. It's just gonna make life so much more easier. And this is like perfect for small boob girls because it is that super high elegant neckline and it's got this like open back moment. The way I styled my hair is having it in a really, really nice low bun and just having little bits out. I feel like this, because of the simplicity of this dress, it would look so nice with such like bold statement pieces of jewelry. I like really neutral small kind of necklaces, but with your earrings you could go all out, with your shoes you could go all out, your handbag as well, you can go all out. And the amazing thing about thrifting and buying dresses like this that are so much more cheaper and more affordable is that like, because I've spent $1 on this, I can go all out on like my makeup, on my hair if I wanted to, on the accessories that I wanted to, and you don't have to break the bank. The last dress that I have to show you guys is this dress. Now this isn't necessarily a formal dress kind of wear, but just imagine this just a little bit longer. Rather than having that kind of penguin line kind of dress where it kind of goes up-ish towards your knees, imagine that this is like a long ruffle straight cut dress. This would be like a Zimmerman dress, and honestly that is just goals in life, to have a Zimmerman looking dress but pay like literally a fraction of the price. I got this dress from the Sabo skirt pop-up sale, and I'm pretty sure I bought this. I don't know the calculations, but I know I paid $50 to fill a bag of clothes, and I remember getting like 6 pieces or so. So this dress really didn't even cost that much. It is so beautiful. Although it's not very formal dressy, I wanted to keep this as an option in this video to show you guys because of the cut and how it looks and everything. So we have this first part of the dress. It's just like this bodice kind of ruffled top corset looking piece, and you can just slip your arms into this like so. I know this like milkmaid kind of top is a little bit more intimidating to small boob girls because they feel like they need to have boobs to be able to fill it. But honestly, I feel like even if you just wore like sticky cups inside this, it would be fine. No one's really gonna notice the difference. And I feel like it's gonna be so much more comfortable for you anyways, not to have like such huge boobs or huge cleavage out, because people aren't gonna be staring at that area, and it's just gonna make it more overall comfortable for you throughout the whole night. You won't get catcalled, you won't get any inappropriate comments, which, you know, would be ideal. And then this next part, you just tie it at the back, and then this dress kind of just sits on your hips and falls at your hips. So there's kind of a little bit of like a disconnect in this dress, in which you can see the triangle cutouts on your side, and again, the back is open other than like this little part here that ties at the back to kind of keep it. So it kind of looks like a two-piece, but really it's just one dress that's connected by this little bit of material in the middle. This dress is honestly so beautiful. The pattern and the floral are so beautiful. I feel like floral could honestly be really in with formals and proms. I've seen a lot of TikToks of girls doing like Bridgerton style kind of formal dresses or prom dresses, and they honestly look so beautiful. And I know that lace and florals are really in, so it really doesn't matter what the standard kind of is with formal dresses. In the time that I went to formal, people were wearing like those really like elegant kind of gowns. People were spending lots and lots of money on their gowns, like $500 to $1,000. But really, it doesn't really matter at all if you choose to make your dress, kind of find it at like a pop-up sale like I did, or a thrift store and kind of repair it. All these random places that you necessarily wouldn't think about looking for, that's where you kind of find the most unique and best kind of formal dresses for yourself. Before we go, the last tip that I have for you guys is this. Sticky covers and nipple covers are gonna be your best friend. Try not to wear a bra to your formal, just mainly because it's literally not gonna be very comfortable. And a lot of dresses, especially if you're buying really formal kind of made wear dresses, they're already gonna have like the built-in kind of bra or cuppages in them. And so you really don't even need to wear a bra at all. It's probably best to just wear one of these just in case you're like dancing around and stuff, or you know, taking photos all day. There aren't gonna be any wardrobe malfunctions. That'll be great. Yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already. I post a new video every single Thursday. And leave a comment down below. When was your formal? Or if you're going to formal this year, when is it? And if you have anything planned already to wear, what are you gonna wear? Let us know down below. I hope you guys enjoyed, and I will see you all next week. Bye.